Hey guys, what's up? Welcome back to my channel. Welcome to my channel. Hi, I'm Akanksha. I hope you guys are enjoying the Navratri series. And yeah, this look is something you guys asked for. You guys asked for something very minimal and very nude. For me, nude would be something which is more matte. And that's the reason there's like not a lot of shine except for the inner corner. A little bit on the cheeks, but you know, a little more matte type of look. And because it's festive, I did add a little bit of highlighter. So, but usually it's a little more matte and a little more like, you know, playing with brown tones. So that's what I created. And yeah, if you want to know how I did this look and how I prepped my skin, etc., then keep on watching. So yeah, let's start off with a little bit of skin prep. On a festive day, we want a little bit more glow, a little bit more brightening effect. You want our skin to look really flawless, but not like, you know, dry and dehydrated. So my skin, it's winter is here and almost, and in winters my skin is like a little dry. So first I'm just going to use the Tribe Concepts Kumkum Adi Tailam. I'm just going to like, you know, take proper amount of it and I'm going to massage it on my face. It gets absorbed really quickly. On their website they do say like apply it for, you know, 30 minutes and then rinse off, but I think if you have dry skin, you can definitely use this like a facial oil which you can, you know, put overnight as well. But of course I have a little bit of oily skin, so what I do is I always like put this on in the, you know, before rinsing my face. So I just like put it on like for 30 minutes and then I like go in with their cleanser. All right, it's been more than an hour. I got carried away. I had lunch, I tweezed my brows, shaved my little mustache. Whenever I say stash, I remember my friends. But yeah, let's do face cleansing. So for cleansing, now obviously in the morning you don't want to strip your skin away from the essential oils. In the night it's fine, like, you know, throughout the day you build a lot of gunk, but in the night once you do your skincare and you sleep, there's not much left on the please ignore the construction sound. It's constantly like not only my house but the house right next to me, like this is my window and that house getting renovated, the sound is so bad. So from morning like 6 o'clock to night, it's like, it's always like, please stop. So I'm using the Tribe Concepts Face Brightening Powder. So this is like a very gentle powder, more like a normal makeup powder you use. So I'm just going to take one spoon of this, mix it in a bowl, add a little bit of water and gently massage it. So I just make like a paste. I actually added a lot. You don't have to add so much. It's very, very gentle. A few people have asked me like, you know, it looks very harsh on your skin. Maybe it's because of the color, but it's quite gentle. Like there's nothing abrasive about this. So you can, you know, gently massage this on your face and you know, keep massaging like for 1 to 2 minutes and then you can rinse it off. So I just rinsed it off and I just want to do a little more extra before going in with my makeup. So I'm going in with the Tribe Concepts Face Glow Mask. So I really love this one. I've spoken about this so many times. It's like almost over because it has turmeric. It has that touch of like that brightening effect instantly. And like, of course, you know, if you keep using it, it has its own benefits. So I'm just going to like again take in the same bowl. I usually mix these things with like rose water or something. So I'm just going to do the same thing. It has red sandalwood, marigold, rose, licorice, shironji, couscous, wild turmeric, cinnamon, camphor and nothing else. Because they're powders, you need to be really careful that you keep them in a very dry place, because obviously any powder, let it, not only this one, if you like have exposed it to too much moisture or anything, they kind of lump a lot and they get spoiled. One thing I really have to point about this brand is the sustainability factor. They don't use plastic. Even when it gets delivered, it comes in like a cardboard box and the powder inside this tin comes in like a paper bag. So it's really nice. And if you have to like repurchase this, you don't have to purchase the entire thing. You can just purchase the inside sachet, which is available separately. So you don't have to like have multiple cans of this and you don't know what to do, which is really amazing. And like that means, you know, they put thought into the product and how to like make it the best for, you know, the customer and the environment. Alright, outfit change, lens on, hair a little bit done. So let's start off. I'm sorry, I think I'm going to do this like a voiceover type of video because there's so much construction sound and I don't want you to guys like, you know, to get irritated. Maybe I'll do like mix of voiceover plus chatty video. And I just want to quickly mention the festive kits by Shreya Jain from MAC. These are super super, super value deals if you want to check it out. So MAC has collaborated with Shreya Jain, which is, first of all, so proud. And they created three beautiful festive kits. So one is the red kit, which is known as Laat-ish. Then the next, they have the blue kit, which is the Desi Girl edition. In this, they have three lipsticks. And then is the Tere Naina kit. So I was on Instagram, what look do you want to see? So a lot of people told minimum. So I'm going to recreate Shreya's lipstick. So obviously I'm going to replace this lipstick with something more neutral, because you want a very minimum new type of makeup look. But just to give her a moment, like, she looks so stunning. So yeah, I just, like, you know, thought I'll recreate the same look. It's so nice, like, just like a very soft base with a very, like, soft eye and a bold lip. And by the way, these lens are these Russian Velvet Green from Olens. I think Olens is by far the most comfortable lens I've tried. So I'm wearing the green lens. I'm wearing green lens for the first time. I think I really like
it. So we're starting off with the MAC Fix Plus.
So don't mind my sunscreen if it balls up a little bit. It'll just go away once I put something. You know, I girl wants to just protect her skin. Okay, don't mind.
Next, I'm taking the LA Girl Concealer in the shade Almond. I'm going to go in with a sheer medium coverage foundation, so I'm just using this to, like, you know, conceal any discoloration around the mouth. I just added a little bit and I'm blending it with the Lakara E006 brush. I added it just on the areas where I think I need a little more coverage, that is around the eye, the inner socket of the eye, and around the mouth. Next, I'm going in with the L'Oreal Infallible 24-Hour Fresh Wear Foundation in the shade 260. Then I'm using the Real Techniques Buffing Brush and I'm just blending it out. When you don't have time, brush is like the easiest and quickest way to blend. So I'm just applying like a thin layer on the entire face. I'm making sure I get it everyone. On my forehead, I usually don't apply. So I just apply the center a little bit. Then I'm going in with the sponge and making sure like everything is even. Then I'm going in with the LA Girl Concealer in the shade Medium Beige now. And I'm going to highlight the under eye. It's actually not that highlighting. It's just, it kind of matches my skin tone, but it's a little lighter. So I'm just concealing. We want to keep it very basic, so we don't want to do like extra something, and I'm just blending it with the same brush again.
So usually what I do is I add extra amount of concealer on the eyelids, but we want to keep it very minimal, and the way to keep it very minimal is always to go in with less eyeliner around the eyes. Once you don't use a concealer, or if you use really less concealer, it kind of, your makeup tends to look a lot natural. Of course it won't like look as you know, what do you say, contoured and highlighted, but it will give you that very soft look. So I'm just going in with whatever is left on the brush on the lid. Usually what I do is I like do my brows, carve out the entire brow, then add like a thick concealer. But now I'm just going to, like, you know, lightly dab the concealer which is left on my brush in, and then going to go in with eyeshadow. So it looks like a very thick, natural look.
Then I'm taking the Laura Mercier translucent powder and I'm just setting the under eye. Make sure there are no creases. Under eye, I'm using a sponge. The rest of the face, I'm just using a brush. I'm lightly dabbing all the powder on the entire face. You want the makeup to stay from morning to night, so make sure you set your face really well. Next, I'm going in with the Wet n Wild contour powder and I'm just adding it on the outer parts of my face and lightly dabbing it. I don't want the bronzer to be too strong, so I'm just adding it a little bit. Then I'm going in with my brows, with my Precisely My Brow pencil. I'm just brushing the hair and filling it. I don't do much for my brows. I just fill it in the starting and I kind of brush it off. I make sure I don't go overboard because I already have thick brows. I make sure I go, like, you know, very less and just set everything in place. And next, I'm going in with an Iconic eyeshadow palette. I'm taking like really, really less amount of product and using it as a blush. I don't have a very soft coral kind of blush, so I just like went in with that eyeshadow because that color is perfect. Then I just add a little bit of Fix Plus to set everything in place.
So her look is more like warm tones, like more oranges, like that coral type of colors. But I want to keep it more nude and brown, so I'm going to use like more browns. It's the same technique, but that's just like, you know, different colors.
So yeah, first I'm just taking these two colors, it's like pretty self-explanatory, and adding them in the crease. I want a very, very soft touch of color. I don't want anything like, you know, too much. So I'm taking a very fluffy brush and like lightly blending everything off. Then I went into the deeper brown. I didn't go with like really strong brown because I don't want it to be strong again. So next what happened is I thought it became a little stronger than what I wanted. So I went in with that half white or cream shade and dusted off on the entire crease to tone it down, and it did help a lot. For the lower lash line, using the same shade which I used in crease before, then going in with a metallic shade. I didn't want it to be that strong, so that's the reason I gave that expression. So I'm kind of toning it down a little bit and dispersing the color and like adding it properly. Next what I did is I took a fluffy brush. I showed the brush because I usually don't apply with like metallics the fluffy brush, but I wanted to be very, very soft, so I just took a fluffy brush and added that same shimmery shade on the lid. Then I went in with nose contour because I forgot to do nose contour. And yeah, lastly I'm just like curling my lashes, adding the brush. Actually brush is Fay Beauty's new launch, so it's a brow mascara plus a lash mascara. So I'm just like, you know, adding that brow mascara and then going in with the mascara as well. Next, usually I always apply two like mascara, so I'm going in with the Lash Paradise and adding that a little bit as well. Then I'm going in with the MAC Kajal, which comes in Shreya Jain's Tere Naina kit, and I'm just tight lining my waterline because I don't like a wide gap between my mascara and my, you know, lash line. Then I'm just taking the Maybelline Master Chrome highlighter and highlighting. Actually added a lot. Then I'm, you know, trying to diffuse it. I diffuse it almost like entirely. I just want the touch of glow to be there. I don't want anything too strong. Like I'm just adding the same thing on the nose as well. Then going in with the LA Girl lip liner in the shade Hazelnut, and I'm just like outlining the lip. I'm actually, you know, getting it to the center because I'm kind of creating an ombre lip. Then I'm using the Revolution Blush Nude Lipstick in the shade Undress, and I'm just adding it in the center. And next I'm just going in back with the same liner and like darkening the edges because I want that like soft ombre look.
And yeah guys, that's it for the makeup look. I hope you guys like it, and happy Dasara to everybody. Tomorrow is Dasara obviously, or else like whenever you're watching, happy Dasara. And yeah, I hope you enjoyed the video, and if you did, then make sure you like, share and subscribe to my channel and ring the notification bell. It'll be in the absolute world for me. If you want to check all the videos of Navratri, I have a playlist named Navratri, so you can check that out. Whatever videos I uploaded during these 9 days will be in that. And yeah, that's it for the look. Thank you so much for watching. I'll see you guys in my next video.